Greetings, denizens of the internet, and welcome back to another Raging Reality reaction video. Now today, guys, we are returning to Rage Against the Machine. Now, it's becoming something of a special occasion now where we'll be able to talk about Rage Against the Machine, because if you're like me and the very first time you heard it was, for me, the very first time I heard this group, and I mentioned this, I'd imagine some other people just like me, about 10 or so years ago, when all of a sudden, for almost no provocation whatsoever, Killing in the Name of made the Christmas number one in 2009. Almost 10 years ago when this happened. But you know what? I'm very glad it did. Not because, you know, it pissed Simon Cowell off, but mostly because that was, for me, really my first introduction to hard rock, heavy metal, and Zach De La Roche, their lead singer. And I've got to hand it to you, Zach is, he's probably one of my, I wouldn't say he's one of my favorite writers, but he's definitely up with the likes of, James Keenan, Neil Peart, Hetfield, Harris. He's got a lot more potential than you might think for what is essentially Tool, if Pantera and Tool use polymerization, then you'd end up with Rage Against the Machine, because they have a lot that they want to say, hence the name. They want to rage openly against a mechanical society. And actually, two other things about that. One, Tool, I am fully aware that Tool have a new album coming out late this year, which I'm so excited to hear that, because I think I'm going to see whether or not I'll be able to react to it the instant it comes out, because usually Tool are very cool about letting people react to their stuff. And secondly, let's just shut up so we can get this party started. So, if you guys want to check out the original video for yourselves, links will all be in the description down below. But before we begin, I want to give this video, I want to give a special shout out to a channel that I follow regularly and such, and I feel like this is the best time to openly talk about this new feature I want to add to the channel, in which just before we begin the videos, I want to give a shout out to a very specific channel. I've been following this guy React Central for several months now, and he poses up these fun little reaction videos, and he utilizes some kind of I don't particularly know what software he does, where he streams and such, but now he has this great feature where you can just see his head coming up. I mean, it's just a fun little gimmick, and they're basically just fun little videos here and there and such, but he's been doing these for a while, and you know, he's a really cool guy. I follow him a lot when he does his streams, and hopefully you guys will be able to check him out, and we'll see where it takes from there. So, if you guys want to check out the original video, and if you want to check out React Central's channel as well, links to everything will be in the description down below, along with the GoFundMe page, which will lead to Anne Weichoff. And I'm delighted to say, updates on that, $1,480. That's all we've got left now to put in the tank to reach our 5K target. So again, just the gratitude and how much people are willing to put in to see this sweet old lady who puts so much into just describing lyrics about Nightwish and other bands, etc., etc., and gives nothing in return for it. So make sure to check that out as well. Really, really sweet lady. And now let's begin. Sleep Now in the Fire. In 3, 2, 1, and... find, well, that De La Roche really, really, really likes to get topical with his music, and I'm absolutely fine with that because there's plenty to get topical with. And I don't, even if like Rage was still performing in 2019, which I think they should, and well, to be fair, Tool are really, really good at this as well. I'd imagine there'll be so much that you can talk and say about society today and such, but for going further than that, this song so far I think is a lot about greed and how we seem to literally take everything except for what we actually need. Because hey, if the desire, the action is there to just literally take something and just run with it, then why shouldn't we do it? Because, you know, we've provided enough, and the logic goes as such, why can't we just help ourselves, even if it's something that we know that other people will go without and would rather need than what we would probably want. That's a luxury as far as we're concerned, but then it could be the difference between life and death for whatever reason. So yeah, I like it. We're getting busy with this. Is that something kids still say today? Probably not. So anyway, let's continue. 3, 2, 1, and... La Vida, the Peter, the Santa Maria, the new sin, the rapist, the field's overseer, the ancient of orange, the priest of Hiroshima, the cause of my desire, sleep now in the fire. Hey, hey, sleep now in the fire. Hey, hey, sleep now in the fire.
Of history, it's caged and frozen still. There is no other pill to take, so swallow the one that made you ill.
Okay guys, that was Sleep Now in the Fire by Rage Against the Machine. I feel pumped up now. I remember actually I was watching earlier today, for you guys who don't know, I follow this reaction channel called No Life Shack. Super, super awesome guy who basically reviews modern rap music, and he's only, let's say, I think it was like in the last 6 months, he's finally decided that he's going to run metal reactions as well. Literally, go check him out because he is really, really expressive, and he is he's got so much likability in this guy as well. And I may as well go the whole hog and introduce his channel as well. So, I mean, only yesterday, as of recording this, he reacted to the song Painkiller. You may have heard of it, from Judas Priest. And I think actually he did Killing in the Name of a few months ago as well. But the point I'm trying to say is that, well, speaking of Rage Against the Machine, they are it's a really, really strong combination of metal and rap. And nowhere is this, I think, a little bit more relevant than among all the other songs I've done so far than Sleep Now in the Fire, because there seems to be a very definite sort of, I don't want to say indication, but there's a very real difference between Tom Morello, Brad Wilk, Tim Commerfield, Epic Lockredis, and Nick Dida, compared to Zach De La Roche. It's, whenever you hear Zach play, it's almost, you may as well just turn the power off right now, and he will be pretty much lay it to you straight. And then you hear, and I don't particularly blame that either, because I like the very, very different contrasts of metal and rock and metal and rap, because hell, you could go so far in one direction, but you could go so far in the other one. And it's really is another bizarre one as well, because when you really think about it, metal and rap shouldn't really work together, because as far as I could work out, in rap, you're going to have to need like lots and lots of space. You need to be the center stage. You can't really have anything else wanting to take your limelight. Mind you, with that being said, I haven't really listened to much Eminem or Dr. Dre collaborations so far on this channel, but that might change sooner than you might think. We'll just have to wait and see for that. But good lord, Zach has that kind of that ruthless aggression Kurt Angle and John Cena once said. It's where you openly want something dear and you will go the whole hog to get it. Now, the point I'm trying to make about something like that is that Zach, I mean, I know fine well at some point I'm going to have to check out Rage Against the Machine in live performances, but Zach has got so much in his voice that I think it would be very, very hard to disguise it on stage. And actually, that is also something I really do need to emphasize as well. If the next time I check out Rage Against the Machine, it might actually have to be Killing in the Name of Life, because I want to see Zach de la Roche perform live, and I'm sure there are still things you want. Yeah, I've got plenty of things still to do. Please keep quiet. I would love to see Zach perform live. I want to see just the motions he goes through, because I've seen the music video for Killing in the Name of, and he looks bizarrely really composed, but he looks like he owns the stage like a rapper would. I don't know why, but it's just, I think there's a good reason why. I don't know. Are there other groups out there like Rage Against the Machine that could do balance rap and metal so well? I'm not talking about Limp Bizkit. That's more metal and hip hop compared to metal and rap. Those are two very different things entirely. Rap and hip hop. I just wanted to make that clear. But whilst we're on this, I've got to find out, because hey, if Rage Against the Machine can do this, and bear in mind this was a song that came out 20 years ago to this year, I've got to find out whether or not there are other groups that do this as well, because and by the way, actually, before we get off, I may as well talk a little bit of the song itself as such. Now, like I mentioned, it's a lot to do with greed, but one thing I know Zach really likes to talk about, he likes to talk about the shoddiness, just the lies about the greatness of American history. I mean, yeah, the world is my expense, the cost of my desire. Jesus blessed me with its future, and I protect it with fire. He wants to make sure nobody comes anywhere near his possessions. And I protect it with fire. So raise your fists and march around. Just don't take what you need. I'll jail and bury those committed, and smother the rest in greed. Crawl with me into tomorrow, or I'll drag you to the grave. I'm deep inside your children. They'll betray you in my name. And this is about, obviously, the idea of greed. It sinks itself so deeply that nobody, not even your own offspring, will be able to stay loyal to you, because if they see opportunity, then they'll take it. And this is true. Opportunistics, it's in the name. They'll find an opportunity and they'll do everything they can to just take it all for themselves. And you know, and obviously they list a lot of examples here, like Agent Orange of the Vietnam War, Hiroshima. They go, I could go on, but I'm pretty sure, and I think maybe a lot of our older viewers, and well, obviously, now here's the thing, I don't particularly care to know too much about Vietnam, apart from a few films here and there, but obviously I'm not the right person to talk about Vietnam, but I can obviously see where, you know, Zach probably grew up during the end of the Vietnam War, so maybe he just had a few things going through his mind about the traumas of war and such, the thousand yard stare and all like that. Zach reminds me of that, of almost, I want to say, a stereotypical college kid who is very anti-war, who will take part in peace protests, and he will booze it up in his dorm, and just he'll go to lectures really late. Is it weird to think like that? Because Zach does strike to me as like a college kid who decided to just write a song and make it as politically divisive as possible. But literally, despite all that, I really dig the song, just because it's always good, it's always nice, it's always a change to hear De La Roche talk about anything, to be honest. I mean, what was the line? All of these are American dreams. All of these are American dreams. Just hearing that shout passionately at the top of his, that's another thing that's also really, really good for having this combination work so well, is that you could almost smell the passion rolling off De La Roche's enormous hair. is that a good metaphor? I don't particularly think that's a good metaphor, but guys, what more do I have to say? This was just a classic example of a Rage Against the Machine song, and I hope Fine Well will get to listen to more of these in the future, because the more I listen to these, I just want to keep finding out more about what Roche wants to talk about, because he's got a lot in him, a lot of aggression, and he utilizes his aggression to talk about things that actually matter. I salute that. I salute De La Roche for doing that. Even though, I always thought De La Roche was Canadian, but who knows? Someone will help me fix that, and I'll give you a like out for that as well. So anyway, hope you guys have enjoyed this reaction video. Please leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section down below. Let me know what you thought of Sleep Now in the Fire by Rage Against the Machine. Make sure also to like and subscribe to get daily notifications of my videos coming out. And I hope to see you guys again in the next reaction video. Take care. Bye for now. Zoop.